Oi, beer git, get your ass over here. And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer. Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. Tonight, we have got Rothaus or Tannenzapfel, which is a German Pilsner. Now, I tried their Weiss beer not so long ago. I've done a review of it, I'll post it up at some point. These are great brewers, they really are. They're based in the Black Forest in Germany. And I love the labels. The label is fantastic. I don't know if you can see that or not. But that's been going since the mid 50s. That young lady there, her name is Beer Git. Now, I've been called a git before. And I've been called a beer monster. But I've never been called a beer git. Anyway, that's her name. What is this? This is their Pilsner. And as I say, Rothaus, I think it is. Rothaus, means red house in German. They do some really good beers, and I'm hoping this is going to be another good one as well. I've not had this one before. I think this is their Pilsner. It's all in German, and my German, I really should brush up on it, but I can't read a word. It's like Chinese to me. It's 5.1% in the volume, and it is 33 centilitres or 330 millilitres. So it's basically half a pint. This, when it first came out, was really unusual for German beer to be served in bottles that small. And again, if you look on the label, I don't know if you can see that or not, but then pine cones. A lot of people think that that means, or it signifies, their brewery location in the Black Forest. But it doesn't. That signifies the beer bottles, how they hang down because they're so small. Anyway, I'm going off on a complete tangent here. Let's open it up and see what's going on. All right. Got a little cap there with the Rothaus. Or red house, however you want to pronounce it. That was covered in gold foil, so you probably wouldn't see that anyway. Oh, what is that? This smells like a dark beer. And I thought this was Pilsner. I could have got this completely wrong. It smells very nutty, malty. And I'm beginning to think this is not a Pilsner, but let's have a look. And it is. It is, but it smells like a dark beer. But that smelled really malty. I would have expected a little bit of citrus on that. Yeah, I'm sort of getting that now. I'm getting little citrus notes, but there's a lot of malt in there. It's very faint, which is unusual. I thought, you know, it would have been quite a fragrant drink, but there's little bits of citrus there and malt, but not a lot. Let's dive in and see what it tastes like. There's the colour first. Very light straw colour, or medium straw colour. Little bit of carbonation, very small head. Let's give it a go. And that is a very balanced Pilsner. There is lager malts, which I can taste, sweet lager malts, a little bit of citrus, and very slight hop sort of finish on it, but it goes down super smooth. It really does. Yeah, sort of biscuity lager malt. Slightly, very slightly bitter finish. Bitter, sort of citrusy finish, but it's a good balance, I think. And it's a very good representation of a German Pilsner. And as I say, this has come out of the fridge, it's cold. It's super crisp, it's very clean. And it tastes really nice. Lovely malt. There's a lovely malty lager malt flavour coming from that. Very tasty. And yeah, it's just a really good representation of a German Pilsner. I really like that. That is good. Yeah. The only bugbear I've got with this is, it's, for all intents and purposes, it's a half pint bottle. This cost me, and it was on special offer, £2.75, I think, which for a bottle this size is quite expensive. I know it's been imported from Germany. They only brew it over there in the Rotzhaus brewery in the Black Forest, but it's very nice. And as I say, they do some good beer, that Rotzhaus. I've had their Weiss beer on draft, and I've had their Weiss beer out of the bowl. That's really nice. This hasn't let the side down at all. It tastes really good. I'm really impressed with that. What would I give that? I would give that a 7.5 out of 10. And I would recommend it as well. It's really good. If you can hunt this down and you don't mind paying for it, and you know you're gonna get a really good cold, refreshing Pilsner, then get this. This is a good one. The price may put some people off because it is slightly dear. That's the only thing. That's why I've knocked a few marks off it, and I always take the price into consideration when I give them these marks. But it's nice. It's not a bad beer. It's only been, the marks have only been knocked off because of the price. But aside from that, it's really good, clean, crisp. Good Pilsner. Very nice. Very nice. 7.5 out of 10. Recommended. And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.